As a brand new sport, when people see this for the first time, they can't quite believe it's real. But the next thing they start asking is, when am I going to have my flying car? That's the reason this sport exists, is to get people excited and to fall in love with this technology.
I just wanted my own flying car. I had this crazy idea, and now all these people have mobilized to make it happen with us. I mean, who gets to do that? Technology development is all about great sequencing. If you go back to the Wright brothers, for instance, they changed the sequence. While everyone else was putting engines on and worrying about the engine, they worried about the control system. Once they got that right, it was just a matter of putting a little engine on and they had powered, controlled flight. That's what we've tried to get right with Airspeeder, is get the sequencing right.
This sport is brand new. It's a blank sheet of paper. So when it comes to designing vehicles, what does a flying race car look like? You had to kind of start from scratch and evolve it from there.
It's difficult when you give high-performance engineering team this kind of blank slate and go, think about what a flying race car could be. It could be anything.
The Mark IV is our first crewed racing vehicle. It looks like a hybrid between a Formula One car and a fighter jet.
I just wanted to create the perfect object. We want to work with the best in everything we're doing. And working with Intel has meant that at the base level, we have the best silicon we can possibly get our hands on.
We use Intel Xeon for HPC and computing at the edge. You've got to think that each of our speeders has 4 cameras and terabytes of data coming out of it. So we need to be really processing all that information at the edge.
Not only is it integral that we've got Intel on board the Mark IV in the flight control system, but also it's powering everything around that. So the virtual course, the fan experience, all the infrastructure that we need to connect the vehicles and broadcast this to the world. But now the build is complete. So the Mark IV, the first Mark IV is standing there complete, ready to start its flight testing. Everything's ready. Just add the pilot now and we're off to the races.